Second time in the bungalow.
So let's get on with the show.
Tell you what, should we do it properly?
What?
Hello!
Hello! It's me and Dom here in the old bungalow, so picking on with that show!
Let's make a bungalow. Morning, bungalow! Come back and let me stay the night in the bungalow. Hope you've had a good night.
Hello, lip broken. Hello.
Hello. Hello. Welcome back.
Hello.
Welcome back, Rod.
Hello. It's Dick and Dom here in the old bungalow. So let's get on with the show.
Okay.
How are you?
Roger is the naughty one if you didn't see the show yesterday. Yeah, thank you, Raja. He's the mischievous one of the bungalow heads. All right, this morning, Raj?
Yes.
Now, let's have a look at your score, first of all, Raja. You've got minus... minus 122.
What do you reckon about that?
Not very good, is it?
Yeah. Not the best.
I've got to say, it's probably one of the lowest scores you've had.
Raja, at the moment, everyone at home is going, why can I just see the back of his head? Do you want to turn around and say hello to them? There they are.
Hello.
Raja, can you do any impressions?
Yes.
Who off?
Nana Moon
from EastEnders.
Yeah, right,
got it. Ooh, Alfie, darling.
Is that it?
Yeah.
Did you do any more?
No.
Uh-huh. It's quite good, though. Let's give you one bungalow point. Now, are you good? There you go, look. Watch.
Minus 121.
There you go. That's good, isn't it? Now, noise. Right. So, are you going to behave yourself today? Yesterday,
yeah.
You were quite mischievous, weren't you?
Yeah.
You're a bit naughty. And you got a gun, didn't you?
Yeah.
How was it?
Bad.
You dodged the gun, didn't you?
Yeah.
Can we have a look at it? Are we going to have a look at it?
Yeah, we'll have a look at it a bit. We'll have a look
all
at
right,
it.
All right, let's have a look at it. This is Raja being gunged. Look at him dodging it!
Why did you do that? You stuck your head right back so you didn't get
you
any on the
it!
Why did you do that?
We'll have to make it up for it today. Thank you very much, Roger.
Press the green button. Who's next? Welcome back, Bungalow Head number 2, Bilbo.
Hey, Bilbo. Hey, I like your get up. I like your out of it.
Liking
I like your night's work.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Did you have a good night's sleep into Bungalow?
I stand there.
Yeah.
Good. You've only got 8 bungalow points at the moment.
Yeah.
Not so good. Mm. How are you going to be better at it?
Win the game.
Win the game. You're better.
Right.
You're better than Raja there, really, aren't you?
Yeah.
All right, now listen.
He's on 0.
Sorry?
He's on 0.
Well, no, he's on minus 21. Yeah, he wasn't minus 22. Anyway, listen, we have got an exclusive photograph of you yesterday with creamy muck muck all over your back.
Look at that. See yourself?
Can you see yourself?
Where?
Why are you looking over there?
What are you looking for over there?
Nice, I'm just looking for the
floor. Well, there you go. And how did it feel having creamy muck muck on your face? What's it like having creamy muck muck all over you?
Fun.
Is it fun?
Yeah.
Would you recommend it to anyone watching at home?
It's fun. It's just fun.
Right, so
it's fun. It's nice.
I think we've cleared that one up. Ladies and gentlemen, it is just fun.
And it makes you feel cool.
Silver, how old are you again?
9.
And Raja, tell us a bit more about Raja. Is he a naughty little kid?
Yeah.
What else does he get up to?
Sometimes he gets up to sneaking on people.
Oh, sneaking on, what sneaking? Show us what it is on Raja himself. Show us what sneaking on people is.
No, like, it's like this, like, you know.
Telling tales?
No. Yeah, sometimes he does do that, but sometimes when we're, like, chatting in my friend's private, he has to come behind us and say he's hiding behind someone. Sometimes he's hiding
behind us. He does that to me.
We do to each other.
He does me.
So, everyone, sneak up on us, too. Come on.
Yeah.
Good. We'll just be over here having a chat. We'll...
Yeah, we hit that.
Bah!
Thank you very much, Silver. Go take a seat. Who's next? Hello, welcome back, Daniela. How are you? All right.
You got Christmas trees on your top.
The Christmassy feel, isn't it?
Hey, do you like all my Christmas decorations?
Yeah.
Nice, aren't they?
Merry Christmas. We know what you got to do last night in the bungalow, you know? Do you know how we know?
If you look at all the corners there, we have CCTV cameras.
Do you know what CCTV stands for? He's not going to tell you.
There's
perfect
television.
There you go.
Do you want... This was 20 past three this morning. And this is what you were getting up to.
Sleeping tablets, they're much better. Are you ready for a bit of breakfast?
Yeah.
Yeah? Are you going to be as excited today as you were yesterday?
Yeah.
Yeah? Are you ready to... Now listen, can you do us a favour today and just keep the noise down a bit?
Yeah.
Charlo. Thank you very much.
Who's next? Welcome back, Ramondi.
Hello, Ramondi.
How are you? Alright, I'm the little mad one. Run around being little and mad. Go on.
Yeah,
yeah, little mad. Yeah, more, more mad. Yeah.
That's all the days you got. Following on from Dilbeer's fantastic impression of Sean Connery yesterday, do you remember that? It was brilliant, wasn't it? We want you to do an impression of someone from Birmingham.
I come from Birmingham!
Now apologise to all the people from Birmingham.
Sorry!
Tell you what, do an impression of Jasper Carrot.
What? You are? Why can't you do it?
Well,
no, you've got to. We're on TV.
It's live. People are paying to watch this.
Yeah, they paid their license. They watch. They got up early especially.
They set their alarm clock because they have a line.
You don't want to say what? You don't know what to say.
Well, I'll tell you what.
Tell him what to say.
The best thing to do now. The best thing to do now is to run around and be mad.
Yeah! Yeah! Welcome back, Callum. How are you, cheeky little monkey?
How are you?
Monkeying around.
You alright? Lovely. Yeah.
Are you well, D?
Good.
Lovely.
Lovely to be in the back of your head.
Khalid, how did you do yesterday? Do you think you did well?
No.
What's your score? Read it to us.
Minus 22.
Minus 22. Problemo, I reckon. How are you going to better it?
How are you going to butter it?
What? How are you going to spread it? How are you going to put margarine?
What? Get some more points.
Get more points.
Get more points.
Hello. There's no water left in it.
It's not very funny when it doesn't work, is it?
No. Well, Khalid, I hope you do get those points then. I hope your tic-tacs work. Thank you very much indeed. And finally, welcome back, Tanya.
Oh, hello.
Hello.
How are you?
Tanya.
Hi.
So are you Tanya, on, I think you forgot to shave this morning.
True.
True.
Mm. It just grew this morning.
Mm. With bits of tape around it.
Yeah.
Nice.
By the way, can I just tell you something, Tanya? Earlier on, I told Daniela to, if she was tired, take sleeping tablets. What I actually meant was, don't take sleeping tablets, all right?
Okay.
What must she not do?
Not take sleeping tablets.
Yeah, what must anyone do under any circumstances?
Take sleeping
tablets. No, don't
take sleeping tablets.
All right, and now what I'm going to do is not make an issue of this whole thing, all right?
And to now,
talking about
and
it.
To now make things better, Tanya's going to do some silly face pulling.
Dad, you really fascinate me, it's got to say. You really do fascinate me.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome back to Bungalow Head! It's Sunday, Dinkin' Dominic Bungalow. Now, yes, yesterday, you obviously spent the whole morning in the bungalow. And,
She's a loony.
Lovely. Dude. Right, Ramandeep, come up here. I want you to tell us which part of the bungalow is your favourite. Go and Creamy point at it.
Creamy muck.
No, don't tell us.
Just point at it.
Go and point at it.
Go and stand next to it and point at it.
Everyone's favourite bit.
Everyone go and point at your favourite bit of the bungalow. Go and
stand up. Point at it. What's your favourite bit? Yeah?
Point at
your favourite bit. You like the antler? What do you like?
Right. Let's just have a look. Over here, yes. Tanya's pointing to the moose's eye.
You like the moose's eye best, do you, Tanya? Ooh, nice. That's good. You wish you had eyes like that. Nice. And they're all... Tell you what, while they're doing that, we'll tell you about the prizes. They can win 3 prizes on the bungalow this morning. If they're third, they'll get third prize, which is that. There you are, that's nice, isn't it? Do you like that?
Yeah, it's very nice. I do like that. I like that size.
Do you?
Very good.
Second prize is a DVD combi and DVDs.
Combi.
Nice.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, it's a combi. Mm. And we've got the first prize as well. First prize, Raja! First prize!
It's a game console.
No,
it's not!
It's not one of those!
It's a pig!
Now, look, you've got some pink modelling clay here. What we want you to do is make some pig masks. What?
Do it! If you want to get involved in the bungalow this morning, you can do one. Here's the prize, idiot. You want to play Cogwallop? How many times will someone smack themselves down the face with a mackerel calling on that number?
Hey, look, can we just ask you a quick question, prize idiot? What weighs more, a ton of bricks or a ton of feathers?
Or about 30 minutes under a medium grill.
Oh my word. You speak any other languages?
Oh, about 12.
What have you got for us?
It's a house.
A house?
you can win a house on Cogwallop today.
I'll tell you what, Nine Gay Shows give away holidays, we give away a house.
Oh my god, oh yeah, no,
your very own house.
900, 500, press 6 to get through to the bungalow. And thank you. Okay. Hello. Flip her off. Oh, hello. Very good.
Hello.
Very good. Get back to the store. Oh, yes. Cheerio. Feed the ferret.
Bye.
Bungalow@bbc.co.uk to email and win.
Oh, we used to love these, didn't we? Yeah.
Use this in the lift. It's always a winner.
Hey?
Hey? Oh, I thought it was a trumping machine. It's just a nuisance machine.
Oh.
What? Hey? What? What was that? That's a fly. You can...
Oh, it does. Mate, listen to all the noise it's making. If anyone calls me. Right there, okay.
Bungalow
if you want to win one for free.
Bungalow@bbc.co.uk. 5 of them to give.
Right.
How'd you get on with your pig mask, Raja? Look at it.
Why are you
bad.
Making it then? Everyone else is doing it over there. Why?
Too fired.
Right,
Raja. Raja's pig mask. Wear it. Wear it. Wear the mask. Turn into a pig.
How's Ramandeep's going? Let's have a look at yours, Ramandeep. I'll try this one on. Hurry up. Like that.
Very good.
Ten points for Ramandeep.
Now, I did say Tanya interests me. She does interest me. I told her to make a pig mask. What she made?
Look at that.
Just a lump of bottling clay.
Any points for that,
Mr. No, those are the ears. That's the nose, the eyes, and the other eye.
You're wrong, she's right. Right then, I'll give you 10 for that as
you're
well.
Right,
then. Daniela! Yours is kind of a bit squashed in, but it's not bad. Not bad at all. Thank you, Daniela. Five points for Daniela. We've already seen yours. Bilba, how'd you go, mate?
Got two.
He's made two!
One for you,
one for me.
A double oink.
His and hers.
A double oink, everyone.
His and hers, pig mask. Any good?
His and his.
20 points for that, because you made two. Nice. And tallied. That. We're all quite good.
Well, there we go. Now,
5 points for you, Khaled.
Check this link. Pigs make bacon. Like it or love it. That's the truth. Bacon is as a breakfast. Breakfast, you can have cereal for breakfast. It's time for the cereal race.
Get your cereal.
serial race game. You've got 60 seconds in which to eat as many of these beans as possible.
Bibs on, bibs on, bibs on.
The person that's eaten the most beans after 60 seconds will get...
80 bungalow points.
So make it more, because then they can start...
180. It is the deal, right, by the way. You've got to eat it. No just flicking around the bungalow, that's easy. Raja, no just flicking it around the bungalow, all right?
Your tongue.
Eat it. Your tongue sharp. Now, take it.
The person with the emptiest bowl gets 180 bungalow points. You all need them, apart from Ramandy, because he's doing quite well at the moment with 253. Cough them up, come on. You're all right, we didn't have to leave.
They're being good. They're being good. Ah. Roger,
you enjoying, you enjoying those cold beans?
Nah.
Nah.
How's it going, Raj?
No.
Enjoying them, Tanya?
Yeah.
Getting a bit on your tash there, love. Mmm. Dilber's wolfing them down.
Oh.
Come on, Dilby. Just leave them to it, really, this lot, can't you? They just do their own thing.
Correct, sir.
They do their own thing. And that's it. You've only got 3 seconds left. Two, one, stop.
Now, in all seriousness, can I just ask, who's dropped their guts?
Well, after that many beans, who wouldn't? Start over at that end then, Mr. Wood.
Oh, my God!
Parky!
Naughty
Parky! What are they all talking about?
I have no idea. I think they're on a different show. You hear that on the bungalow? Wait, telling you guys to shut up.
What?
Shut up. Me shut up? Oh, right, I will.
Look, it's all the way to
that. It's a bad thing. I think he's a flipping Hollywood star now, doesn't he? He is.
It's just bad.
The bungalow.
It's just bad. It's not bad. It's just bad. There's no difference to it.
You cheated. You cheated. You cheated. You didn't. You didn't. You ate them all. It's still there!
180 points. He's the one that dropped his guts! Nice one, mate!
You cheated.
Yeah,
you,
it's fine.
All yours.
It's all over.
No.
It's done.
Finished.
Leave it.
No.
Accept it. Embrace it. It's done.
No.
This is what this lot will be joining in with this morning on Dick and Dominic Bungalow until 11 o'clock. There's going to be a bit of the musical splashes game in a short while.
Okay, we haven't played that in a while. I quite like that. I actually really like that. I really do like that. I'm glad we're about Looney Tunes.
Do you like that too? Do you like that?
Yeah.
Also, the forfeit auction. Oh, the darlings. He's going to be back. Yes, come, Dick and Harry.
Yeah, oh, I like this. I'm glad. I like your money.
Do you know what I really like?
Oh, what's that?
I really like that. It's going to be good, all that, is it? You like that?
Yeah, we like that too.
Do you like that? Do you want a bit of
that? Yeah.
No.
Hey, let's all be at what?
For you.
That's for me.
Big mouth.
Oh.
Here, bungalow heads, work with us, all right? Ow. What can we do to make you happy now?
Just put on in front of the Yukon.
Put on in front of the Yukon. That's handy for, isn't it?
How about if you behave yourselves as a special treat, we'll put it on later. All right? I don't want to sound like mummy or daddy or anything, but it's a special treat. Is that all right?
Yeah.
We're not going to be able to watch anything with Raja standing there.
All anyone will be able to see is your bot instead of Taz. What are you otherwise? Should we just pick?
Oh, Dilber's dropped his guts again.
Hey, Raja! Quick, the prize idiot wants to chat. Quick, off you go.
What?
He's distracted.
Good, right, no, he's gone. Quick. Oh, no.
No. He is there. He's there.
What's he doing down there?
Ow. No, hang on a minute. No, the prize idiot really is here. He's going to pick you up and take you away.
Right.
But he's doing some...
Prize idiot, get back from next door and cut this kid off.
Oh, my friend.
No.
We'll go and have a chat.
Oh, welcome back to Dick and Dominic Bungalow with Dick Dom and the Bungalow Heads. Morning, Bungalow Heads. Have you said morning to your adoring public out there?
Morning!
There, you see, we've trained them now. They're all sitting there nice and quietly. You're fascinated by it, aren't you?
Absolutely brilliant.
Silver brought it for us yesterday.
Couldn't it?
Who is it?
What was his name again? Mandy, that's it.
Mandy.
Mandy. Hello, Mandy.
Did you decide to name him Mandy?
No, it's just his surname.
His name, surname's Mandy.
Mandy.
I think Mandy's had enough. Let's play Cod's Wallop. Right, two callers on the line are going to decide how many times a member of the public will slap themselves around the face with a mackerel. Bungalow heads, then you're going to choose a team. If you're right today, we're going to give you 50 bungalow points.
No.
Tell you what, let's make it 100.
Yeah.
You do have some catching up to do, especially you, Raja. You've got minus 101. Yeah. Right, let's have a look at the person that's going to get slapped in the face with the fish first.
Here they are.
Their name today is...
Matt.
Age?
21.
Hometown?
Norwich.
Norwich, England.
Dropped Nan's dentures into the sewer.
Do you want to do it the other way around? So I'll read those bit. You read the top bit.
Yeah. Most embarrassing fact.
Went swimming in brown pants because he forgot his swimming trunks.
Okay. Mitto.
Mitto? He who dares wins.
Well, there we go.
Could
he
be correct.
Who dares wins.
Could be correct in this game. Phone's ringing.
Your turn.
My turn.
Oh, why you?
Your go.
Go on.
Hello, who's there? Dick speaking.
Hello.
Hello, who are you?
Lee.
What?
Lee.
Lee from where?
Cardiff.
Oh, we were in Cardiff the other day,
weren't we?
Yeah. Were we? Yeah. Weren't
you? I was. What were we doing?
I thought you were there. Maggie.
Oh, are you going?
Hello. Sorry, Lee. Sorry, just having a little conflag there. Lee, how many times do you think the member of the public could slap themselves around the face with it?
100
fish. Thank you very much.
All right, for the very best. See you. I'm going to take the ding-a-ling.
Oh, ding-a-ling.
Hello?
Hello?
Hiya. Hello, who's that?
Hannah Greenland.
Hello, Hannah Greenfield. And where are you from?
Greenland.
Hannah Greenland?
Hannah Greenfield, Greenland.
Or Hannah from Greenland?
Green grass of hope.
Do you know Santa Claus?
Green what? Green grass?
Greenland.
Green snot.
Green, what? Green man?
No, land.
Green land.
No, there's no land.
I think she said green man.
Green nan.
Is your grand green?
Green non.
No,
green banana. Oh, all right then. So, is it Greenland then?
Yeah.
Greenfield.
Hey, sorry, Hannah. It just says Greenfield on there. All right then. And are you well?
Yeah.
Good. That's all I'll take. And look. Okay. Do you want to win?
Yeah.
All right then. Well, how many times do you think that person, Matt, I think it was, is going to slap themselves in the face?
97. Yeah, they are both close today. They're very close. You could win this house, remember, if you're the winner. Ooh. Okay, then we have Lee with 100, Hannah with 97. It's all very close there, Bungalow heads, but choose your team now.
Go!
100 Bungalow points.
I'm 97.
You're 97, I'm 100. Chosen. Good. All right, then, Matt, slap yourself round the face with that mackerel, mate. Controversial way of slapping yourself around the face with a mackerel, I think.
No, I don't think we should let them do that anymore, by the way.
No, if that carries on, we're going to bin it.
You do it like that?
Yeah. Both sides.
Okay.
How many did you get? 127 or something?
Quite a lot.
That means Lee from Cardiff. You've won!
Lee?
Lee, mate.
Thanks.
You just won a house, mate. Thanks. All right.
And Callie didn't do me.
You
win the points. Callum Dilbert, and unfortunately, Hannah Green, have it, Hannah, get rid of that. It stinks. Hannah Greenfield.
Wow.
Do you know what you get?
Is she still saying Greenland?
Nah.
Well, she just hung up.
You get diddly square, Hannah.
Bye.
We'll send you a t-shirt.
Nice one, Dilber and Khaled. 100 bungalow points each. Here, Raja, come over here. Take the chips off your head. Right, we've noticed.
Khaled and Dilber.
You're going a bit thin on top.
Ooh!
You know, you're losing your air at the side here a bit.
Yeah, you're receding already.
We found this in the back of the bungalow cupboard. Restore hair. The cream to give men a new head of hair. So, Raja, come over here.
Raja.
I'm going to put some of this. Hopefully, this will work and you'll get loads of new hair. Let's just stick some of that on there and some of that on there. A bit round the sides there so you get a bit more... If it works, if it does what it says on the tin.
Restored! You've been restored, Roger! Oh,
look at that!
Look at the locks he's got!
I've got to say, Roger.
Have a dance, Roger!
Do a romantic dance.
Oh, Roger!
Hello, Daniela! When's the best time to buy budgies? When they're going cheap! You get it? Cheap! What are you doing with that?
What are you doing with those?
Just getting ready for the pants dance later.
Cleaning the hair restoratory.
Who was that in the toilet? Was it
the coin?
Daniela disappeared.
Daniela!
Hello, love. Come out. I've got to say, having people like you is good on the bungalow, because you're like calm before the storm. You balance out nutters like him. You know, it's a bit of yin and yang. You're the yin, he's a yang. Oh.
Harder.
I take that all back.
Harder.
Hey, listen, let's just have a calm moment with Daniela's face.
What? Look. This is the picture.
This is the picture
No, look over there.
Oh, and there's Roger in it as well.
There's a well-behaved child. That is a well-behaved. Now, Roger, come over here.
Now, Roger, come over here. And listen to the music change when you get a nice shot of Roger. Listen to how mad this is. There's Roger. Tell you what, should we spot the difference?
Yeah. It's time for a challenge to spot the difference game, where you analyze two objects that may appear the same. But look a little closer and trust your observations to find the subtle differences between the two creations.
Now then, bugglerheads, behind this curtain we have two tableaus.
Do you know what a tableau is? Well, you'll see in a minute.
Two things that are completely different. They've got different things about it. Two creations. They've got different things about them. You have to spot the difference in 30 seconds. Write down as many as you can on the whiteboard, and the person with the most differences will get...
300.
Ooh. You could go straight into the lead
and
with this.
And one bungalow point.
301 bungalow
point. No, listen, you've got to look carefully. That's the clue, because these two tableaus are very, very similar.
They are.
So you're going to have to look really carefully for these differences. They're not very obvious.
Okay, bungalow heads, are you ready? Hop, they're different.
There you are.
That's that one there, and that's the other one.
Spot the difference.
Give us your pens, put your pen lids on, and stick all your pens on the table.
Stop. Put your pens on the table. Put the pens down.
Let's start over here with Roger.
Oh, yeah,
look. Pencil case. Security measure. Last week they cheated.
Go on then.
Right. Roger, we're starting with you, and you've
You got feet? Yes, these dildos have got feet.
That one and the other one has.
Yeah. Take? Yes.
Well, it's a pork pie, but we'll let you off.
Yeah, we'll let you off. Tray? Is that a tray?
Yeah, it's a tray.
Yeah, it's a tray. Yeah. Body? Now.
They're just words.
He's got a body. He's got a body. Here it is. His body.
Well, he's right.
He's right. He's got a body. Right. And a leg.
Yeah, he's got legs.
Well, no, actually, they have both got legs. This trolley's got legs.
That trolley's got legs.
Yeah,
so we're not going to allow that.
No, we're only going to allow you.
Because this trolley is down. Please. Get back.
There you are. You got four, Raja. Dilbert, how'd you get on, mate? You got feet, arms, face, body, cloth, and logos.
Clothes.
Log on.
I say clothes.
Logos. Oh, yes, that's the logos. Logos. Right. Right, we'll give you 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We'll give you 6 then, Dilba. Nice one. Next, Khaled. Khaled, you have swimsuit, eggs, and foo. What does that say in the middle?
The eggs.
You don't know. You wrote it down and you don't know what it is.
Yeah.
Okay,
maybe. You only got one there.
Tanya, we got one's a scuba diver, the other one's not, correct. We got one's a cake, the other one's not, correct. Mask, yes. Ribbon, yes. Tray, yes. Mixer.
Yeah.
Where's the mixer? Oh, the
bread! Sorry, Frogman, you got a very well done, Tanya.
Yeah?
There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Not bad.
Well, six. Okay. Six
differences.
Look at them. One's a scuba diver, and one's a fripper. Friper.
Where's the sound
effect? One's a fripper.
Well, where have you had this?
Where's
the sound effect?
I've got the M.
He's whacking me with a mallet and there's no noise. Come and try again. Let's see if they're going to give us 10 out of 10. There you are.
Lovely.
All right. Stop the sound effect.
We're trying to resolve a game here, Raja.
He's a well-behaved little one. Listen to me, isn't he?
Right, listen here. Right, hang on 2 seconds. Oh, no, stop it a minute. Stop a minute. If you're not careful, what's going to happen is this. That frog man... Come here. Stand on there! Keep still!
What's the phone? It's a... Right, that'll do. Right, put it down. Right, resolve it.
Right, okay, right, it's finished. Swimsuit and goggles.
What about Daniela?
That was Daniela.
Oh, that was Daniela. There is one. Two people in a draw here. Tanya and Dilbo both got 6, right. Let's just split the points. 150 bucks points. Nice, well done.
Dick and Dom, who's the daddy? I'm the daddy, and that's that.
Are you still here?
Yeah. So, take your cake and eat it.
Thank you.
Take your pork pie and eat it. Here's what the bugler is. Bugler scores look like at the moment. Raja has still got minus 101. That's not right, no.
No, 508.
Daniela with 165.
Remedy is 253.
Khaled with 133.
And Tanya, 157.
Nice, not doing bad, bungalow heads. Who's in the lead at the moment? Dilber in the lead at the moment with 508. Nelson Dilber. And who's in last place?
Right.
It had to be, didn't it? Raja. Anyone else in last place? No.
We're not even
going to explain what you're going to do here. You know what you're going to do. Go on, you just do it. We'll leave you to it.
Where did you put that?
What?
Not those. Where's the one I had yesterday? Yeah, even though I got dirt on it. Put that one is here. Put that one is here. Mess it up.
Tell me what to do. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it's the Raja Show.
I've got my head in my pants.
Raja, you've danced in your pants on Dick and Dom in the bungalow?
Yeah. So what?
It's boring. I'm
you want to go,
anyone else?
If you're bored, go.
Oh, you're back again, are you?
Yeah.
You want some more?
Yeah, I want
this. All right. Every Sunday morning in the bungalow, in the airing cupboard, we have a big person who wants to air their views on something. They want to complain about a certain subject. And today...
It's all right, it was drink the magic potion, and now everybody ignores me. It's almost as if I'm not here. I don't have a problem. Do you have a problem? We all have problems, but I'm just see-through. I go to a party and people just ignore me. I see a pretty girl, approach them, bid them a good evening, and they scream, run away. I shall never be married unless you marry me. Shall we be married? All of us, shall we be married? I'd love to marry all of you lot. Then I could live a normal life. But when I go to the doctor, I say, Doctor, can you see me now?
Step
he says, no. I tell him that's my problem. He says...
Shut up, man, when we get to the door! We'll come back to you later. Right then, thank you, Invisible Man. All right, over there, Dom.
Yes. I'm absolutely fine. I'm just dreading the next game.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Same here.
He's perfectly still. A tip of silly grin. But one false move gets a pie on the chin. Musical splashes! Woohoo!
Musical splashes! The idea of this game is perfectly simple.
Well, okay, yeah, very simple. All you have to do is like musical statues, but we use splashes instead of statues. When you hear the music stop, you get a pie in your face. If you move, then you have to sit down. We'll do that to a level one person. Okay, now listen. Honestly, we're going to take away all your bungalow points now. Roger, that will mean nothing to you because I haven't got any anyway. Right, but if you don't play this game properly, we'll take all your bungalow points away. So please put the hedgehog down. Please put that hair gel down. Shoot, let's turn everything you leave. And actually think about this for a second, right? So we're trying to make a television show at the end of the day. We're trying to make a television show, okay? And it's just silly, okay? So can we play again?
Yeah.
Properly?
Yeah.
Okay, we're all friends?
Yeah.
All right? No. We all love each other?
No.
Good. Excellent. Exactly what I was hoping you would say. Now, okay. Now, what are you doing with that gel? Can you just wipe your hands with a pan. Get the gel off your hands.
For goodness sake!
Oh. Oh dear.
Ramdeep, saw ya.
Ramdeep, over here. What have you done? You've already got yourself in the face with it.
You're
eating it. He's eating it.
Don't eat it.
What are you doing? You've got a Santa beer. You're not meant to do that before you... Oh, just... Right, go. Go on.
Don't eat it. That's you, Ashley. Go on.
Who was that? Didn't see, actually. Nobody moved. We start
Silver!
Again. Start the music again.
What was that?
Dilbert. Come over here.
It's definitely a Dilbert decision.
Well, actually, I feel bad about doing this, because you're actually one of the well-behaved ones.
Yeah.
You actually do what you're told, and don't do what you're told not to do. So I feel a bit mean doing this.
But
should we give him a... No. Luke, no.
Okay.
Should we let him off? Actually, do you know what? I'm actually feeling quite nice. Oi! No, oh no.
Are you
quiet? No. Yes! I don't know what to do. I don't know what to do. Oh. I have no control over these guys whatsoever. And I don't know how to control them. I have no idea.
Come on, sarcastic face!
Right then, who was it?
Didn't see again.
Damn. All right, start the music
for a few seconds. I'll do.
I think it was over here.
Khalid?
Come on, my friend. Actually, he's never nice, isn't he?
Khalid is the most sensible, I think.
You are the most sensible, you're most well-behaved, and...
Sorry, mate. Who's next? Come on, who's next to the playing?
Oh, yeah, the winner will get 162. One of those boys.
Done. If you're the last one standing, you'll get those points.
What's that? I think it was Daniela. Yeah,
Daniela.
Now
again, Daniela. You know.
I can't do that. Look, face everyone at home. As we said before, the face of innocence.
There it is.
The face of a child
who wants nothing more on a Sunday morning than a great big fat pie.
Lovely. Who's next? Come on, it's between Roger and Tanya. Who's going to get the 162 Bungalow Boys or a pie in the face? Oh dear, who was that?
I think it was Roger.
Do you reckon he's, yeah.
Did you move? Are you moving now? Are you moving?
Roger. No, oh, Roger! Roger!
Come here. You'll get the tension.
Dick and Dom in the bungalow. Normal service will be resumed once the bungalow heads belt up. In the meantime, here's some music.
Painful thing that kind of sticks it all together, doesn't it?
Welcome back to Sunday's Dick and Dom in the Bungalow. We've calmed them down, you'll be pleased to hear. And here's what's coming up on Dick and Dom in the Bungalow this morning. Until 11, my little darling. There's going to be a bit of the forfeit auction with Tom, Dick and Harry in a bit.
Yes, also you can see a bit of Gammon Dow Moon.
Lovely. If under the Yukon, yes, another good cartoon for you in a bit.
After that, you can see Bad Girl or Bad Girl.
With Francis, we're going to be doing the Francis. And not forgetting another bit of Looney Tunes for you too. So stay tuned, thank you. But now, we haven't done this one for a while, have we? We're going to blow up your bot.
Okay then, Bungalowheads, stand by your pumps. We got three teams of two. They're split up into the pumpers and the bot-bots. Okay, you got 1 minute on the clock. Try and inflate your friends' bot-bots as big as possible. Now, the person who's got the biggest bot-bot after a minute will be the winner of
200 Bungalow points. Come on, you can't start
Then. It's all about teamwork. Come on.
All about teamwork. Blow up your bot-bot.
Come on. Come on, you
spam them.
Come on, little bit.
The team with the biggest will get the point.
Come on.
That's 200 points.
Look at your bot-bot.
Come on, look at that.
Look inside. They're big, aren't they?
There's your tape measured on to measure it.
Look at Daniela's big purple bum.
Look at Ramondi's big green bum.
Look at Raj's big red bum.
Daniela's.
Look at all of their big bums.
Daniela is looking biggest at the moment. Come on, you're going to try and beat Daniela because of that pumpy, pumpy, rumpy.
Oh, dear.
Pump it up. Pump hard. You've only got 10 seconds left. 8, 7, come on, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1,
stop.
Time's up. Zero time left.
Someone's got a leak.
Someone's got a leak.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, Daniela's is leaking. Quick. Measure this one. Quick.
Quick.
Right, okay. Measure Daniela's first. You do that one first, and I'll do this one.
Take that in the
tent, please. At the widest point.
Right, over here, it reads, in inches...
Yes?
70.
70? Over here...
That's a good bot, that.
In inches, on the widest part, it reads... I've got that wrong, haven't I?
What does it say?
Come over here and have a look. Help me. They're centimetres, aren't they?
No, they're the same as mine.
That can't be right. 30?
What have you done?
Start the... You do it. I didn't get math GCSE.
Take that end round. It's 67. No, 70.
70.
70. How did you get 30?
I don't know.
It's magic.
It is.
Okay, now over here, Raja, you've done as well.
You've got 65.
65.
So it's a tiebreak situation. It's a tiebreak situation. And to explain the tiebreak, Mr. Dominic Wood.
Right. Now then.
He's still pumping his bot up here.
Oh, what are you doing? No, it's the first person to disconnect their pump from the pump.
Pump what?
the tube with the bomb. Don't do that. Actually, I lied.
Don't do that.
You'll fly off.
I lied. You'll go through the ceiling.
Oh, it's too late. They've already done it.
I mean, it could be a good idea, but...
They've already done it. Khalid and Remedy, well done. You're the winners.
Yeah! 200 bungalow points each. Those 200 bungalow points each to Ramandeep and Khalid onto the scores. And let's have a look at the scores on the Scout Trip Hazard scoreboard now. Rajar has got minus 101. Gilbert has got 508. Daniela's got 165.
Ramandeep's got 453.
Khalid's got 333.
And Tanya's got 390.
In the lead with 500 is Gilbert. You're in the lead.
Oh,
it's
not fair.
It's not fair, because you never told us that we have to drift. You said do it now.
What? Do what now?
No, you didn't say do it now, but they did now, Khalid and thingy.
What's she talking about?
Ramandy, she's the pump thingy.
You got a small point.
What's your point again? You said do it now.
Yeah, no, you didn't say do it now, but they did.
What, now?
No, the pumping thingy.
You don't want to pump now?
No, for the tie break.
For the tie break.
Oh.
Yeah, so it's
right,
well,
maybe do you think, because I'm sure the bungalow heads agree as well, the bungalow head viewers. So would you think that the fair thing to do would be to give you those points as well?
Yes.
Would you let me off the hook then?
Mm-hmm.
Would you stop giving me grief?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Who's your teammate, Daniela?
Mm-hmm.
All right, well, you can have the same points as well.
See, so easy.
That's a happy day.
That's what we want in the bungalow. Remember, those points will mean prizes at 11 o'clock today. The prizes are, third prize, that.
That's third prize. With big eyes.
Yeah.
Also, we've got a second prize. Second prize is a TV, DVD, combi with DVD.
Yeah, that's a mouthful. And first prize is the games console with games and games console with games with a portable lift up bit and have a look at it. It's lovely.
Ah, lovely.
You're all wanting it. Well, at 11 o'clock we'll find out who's going to get it.
She'll be ready for the forfeit auction in a bit. There you go. By the way, where's one of you missing? Who's missing? Tanya?
Yeah.
Has she got to do a lump of chunk?
Yeah.
Tanya?
Tanya! What game do horses like to play? Stable tennis! That's one of my favourites, mate. I like that one. It's got so much in it.
Well, let's go get her out. Let's go get her out. Get on, go. Tanya. Come out of here. And do us a favour. Open the airing cupboard. And just have a chat with the person inside.
People just look through me. They just pretend like I'm invisible or something. But I'm not invisible. That Raj has a bit of a nutcase, isn't he? I'm not here. Do you see? I see you. But do you see me? You see, that's the conundrum I face in my everyday life. I'm invisible. I could do a radio show or something. Ouch! Oh! What's going on? Get off of me, please. I'm not you.
No, not me. Thank you very much.
Go on, David. Yes, mine is another barking. Oh, nice one, David. Here, tell you what, we've got something in common. We've got Dickinson. Oh, go on, me darling. Look like you've been down the sunset something. Oh, hold on a minute. Sorry, David. I'll be back with you in a moment. Hello, Tom, Dick and Harry resident. Tom and Dick and Harry speaking.
Yeah, where are you, mate? Where are you? We want you in here.
Oh, what, me darling? Sorry, I was just watching David Dickinson on the telly trying to find another bargain.
Another bargain? But I don't want you to get another one. I want you to come in here and do the talk for the auction.
Oh, all right then, me darling. See you in a bit.
All right then. Ta-da.
Sorry, David Dickinson. I'll be with you soon. Take care.
Deary me, honestly. Come and get the staff out there. Now, ladies and gentlemen, live from the bungalow, courtesy of the BBC, with the magic of television, transported from his living room to the front door in the wink of an eye. Please welcome Tom, Dick, and Harry.
Oh, me darlings, I can't believe you disturbed my David
there, me darling. What? Who's this lot then? What? This week's Bungalow, Ed. I've been watching you, you know, before I was watching David Dickinson. You're right handful, aren't you? Are you all having a good time?
Yeah.
Not yet. Well, I'm Tom Nicodemus, and this is the fourth auction. This is part of the show where you can fit up your bungalow mates. Who's got a question? What's the question, Roger?
He kicked me in the back.
He kicked you in the back?
Oh,
well, that was nice thing on it.
Yeah. Did it really hurt?
Yeah.
Well, we don't like violence. No, we don't have violence. Remedy. 453. We're going to take away 50 bungalow points. I think that's fair. You've now got 403. As good.
Lovely.
No violence.
The points are already going down. Right then, my darlings. Mr. Dominic, what are you? We'll read out a forfeit and then you can buy it with your bungalow points to stitch up your bungalow mate. There's the first one. Lot 103.
Okie dokie, listen up.
Lot 103.
The hula hula kid. The proud owner of this will wear a dress up and a straw skirt, Hawaiian shirt, and wear flowers around the neck. Every time we see them until the end of the show, they must be spinning a hula ring. If not, they lose points equivalent to the number of seconds it takes them to react. Okay, now, so whenever you hear this music,
hula.
But if it takes you 3 seconds to get to do that, then we'll take away 3 bungalow points. If it takes you 10 seconds to do it, then we'll take away 10 bungalow points.
Lovely. All right, then, darlings, who wants this? It's the hula kid. We're going to start it at 10 bungalow points and it'll go up in 5. Roger's giving me 10 and Daniela's coming with 15. Roger's giving me 20. Anyone going to give me more than 20?
Oh,
Daniela's giving
me
25, but Callie's giving me 30. Anyone giving me more than 30? Roger's giving me 35. Delby's giving me 40. Roger's giving me 45. Anyone going more than 45? It's with Roger for 45 bungalow points at the moment. Ramandeep, are you tickling your neck there? Hold on a minute. I'm just looking at the scoreboard over there, Roger. You've actually got minus 101 bungalow points. How do you expect to buy this forfeit for 45?
You can't.
Right then, who were we with before Raja? I think it was with Delbeer for 40 bungalow. No, Raja. Raja. Will you go and explain to... I'll tell you, yeah. Right then, Delbeer, it's with you for 40 bungalow points. Who's that? Who else? Anyone coming in with higher than 40? It's going to go to 45. Anyone going to give me 45? Anyone going to give me 45 bungalow points for me? It's with Dalbeer for 40. Anyone going to give me 45? Okay then. Oh, Daniela's giving me 45. All right, then it's going to be with Daniela for 45. Anyone going to give me 50? Anyone going to... I think I'm going to sell it now. I think it's going once. It's going twice. Oh, Ramadine came in just at the end now. Just on one. He's got 50 bungalow points now for this. The Hulu Hulu kid. Anyone going to give me more than 50? It's with Ramadine for 50. Right, I'm going to sell it for Ramadine. Go once. Going twice. Gone to Ramadine.
Ramadine, come over here. Well done. You have used your bungalow points to make one of your mates look really stupid. Let's have a look. Roger, your skin. Sit down, mate. Okay, over here. Ramadine, you had... Well, you just lost 50 points for being naughty and kicking people. Now you're about to lose another 50 for being cheeky and giving someone a forfeit. Have a look. 1, 2, 3. Go. But it will be worth it. Who... Come over here, Ramadine. Who would you like to give this?
Daniela.
Oh.
There you are!
That broke the tension, didn't it? Right then, Daniela, there you go. Off to the bedroom. Go and get changed.
You'll be glad of that, Daniela, when you see the other forfeit, because lot 104 is the Cuttery Kid Bungalow Delight.
Oh, man.
What?
Yeah.
Who's it gonna be? Can we guess? Roger's not going to buy it. He's got no points.
Someone
else is
going to
buy it. Who are they
going to
give it to?
Viewers.
I wonder.
Please, let's hope that. I'm wearing my Christmas trousers, kid. If you get them dirty, you're in trouble.
Why have you got your hand up? What do you want?
I got 101. Not he, minus 101.
He's just having his hand
he's
up.
He's removed the minus. He's now got 101. Are we allowing that?
You know what?
It's good business. It's good business,
it is,
then, isn't it?
It's like Richard Branson.
Yeah.
Let's give you 101 bungalow points. All right. Get on top when you've got that.
That's our Richard Branson sign. He just took away the minus. Now look what he's got.
It's
an airline. Say something.
It's as simple as that. Soon you can have your own cosmetics range.
Yeah.
The world is ah. Now you've got nothing. Yeah.
Get out of that one,
Houdini!
Get out of that one, go on!
No, you don't hit me.
No, that's not going to get out of it.
Now you've got minus 101. You just hit me. Let's take it back to minus 101.
Okay.
Ready? Minus 101. There.
There's the minus.
Yeah. Thinking on. Oh, there's
another one. 101. You're back to where you started.
Right.
Right, let's get on with it.
Back to lot 104. What's it called again? The cookery kit.
What a big waste of time that was. Cookery kit. Bungalow delight. The owner of this wharf, why didn't you just ever sit down? Have you got ants in your pants?
Yeah.
You got nails in your pants?
He's lost the plot.
The owner of this wharf will front a brand new cookery program called Ready, Steady, Muck.
All right, yeah.
They will be making a bungalow delight with a number of different ingredients.
What would those ingredients be?
The main one being a fellow bungalow head of their choice.
Oh, no. We'll start this time. We'll start this at 20 bungalow points. Who's going to give me 20 bungalow points for the cookery kit? Callan's giving me 20. Anyone going higher than 20? Callan, you can't bid against yourself. You put your hand up. Stop running your hand up. You're with you for 20. Anyone else going to give me more than 20? Anyone going for 25? Anyone else going for 25? I think it's going to Callan for 20. It's going once. Going twice. It's going to Callan for 20 bungalow points. Callan, come on over here and collect forfeit.
Okay. 104. Right, let's have a look at your score first of all. Let's have a look at your score. Callan, 1, 2, 3. And do... There you go. And now, for attention.
You can choose who you like, me darling. Don't listen to him. Who do you want to get muck muck all over their head?
Raja.
The whole nation has been waiting for this, Raja. They're all clapping and a round of applause. Oh, where's he gone?
And he's gone. He's legged. He's done it. He's done a runner.
Everyone, Raja's done a runner. No, he's doing the cap flap. There he is.
No, he's not going to do the cap flap.
Raja,
where have you been?
Mars.
Mars? You've been to Mars? Well, thank you very much. Come out, come on, Raja. Come on. Here you go.
You're the chef.
Oh, you've got to take part.
No. Right, Callan is going to be the chef. He's going to cook up a nice meal for you, and you're going to be included in it, Raja. So, hey, look who's back. It's the hula kid, Daniela. Only when you hear the music,
she can
Daniela.
Do it.
Right, do it now. Do the hula.
She can actually do it.
Dolly.
She can actually do the hula.
Do the hula, me dolly.
Very good.
You are pretty good at it.
I'm actually going to give her 15 bungalow points. She'll be good.
You're not bad at all. Every time you hear that music, Daniela, Raja,
go over there.
Go and get some salt and pepper on your head. Daniela, every time you hear that music, you're going to do that, all right? Lovely. All right, then. Welcome back, our chef, the cookery kid, is Khalid.
It's Callie Harriet.
Hey, Khalid.
How are you?
Khalid Harriet. Man.
You all right? Have you got any delights for us?
Yeah. Are you ready for the show? Are you ready for the show? Okay then, no. Ladies and jelly spoons, boys and twirls, this is the CBC Channel. And now on the CBC Channel, it's Ready, Steady, Muck.
Here's your host, Khalid.
It's your show. Present it.
Listen, Khalid, it's your show. Go and get Raja, please.
Raja,
I don't know what to do.
Come on.
Raja, are you going to do it? Yes or no? Yes or no?
You can take my own bungalow points.
Of course you are. Come on.
No, don't do that.
You can take
my
own bungalow points.
Yes, yes. Go after him, Mr. No, wait. No fighting. No fighting. No, wait. Here, look, Raja, wait. Hang on a minute. Raja, are you going to do it?
No.
Why?
Because
get out. Well, no, come on. Am I fair? If he's not taking part in the games, and he's just misbehaving, but we've got no bungalow points to take away.
The problem is, mate, if he doesn't do it, it means you've got to do it.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
No, I'm leaving.
Well, I can use it. Get out. Get out. Right then, who's going to do it? Who's going to do it? Right, I'm going to do it. You leave them, and I'll do this.
Brilliant. Brilliant. Get that off.
I'm doing it.
Here we go.
Tell you what, someone else get in with me too. Come on.
Come on.
Jump in.
Jump in.
Everyone get in.
Lovely. Three maximum, that's it now. No more.
Step one. Take
your
bungalow head and in a large bowl.
Okay, yeah, we've done that. Get in a large bowl. Okay, yeah.
Step two. Crack your eggs in a bowl.
Wait, 2 seconds. Stand forward and we'll just hear you a little bit clearer. Come on. Step two.
Crash your eggs in a bowl and pour contents over the bungalow heads.
Okay, right, so that's step two. Crack two eggs into a bowl and pour contents over a bungalow's head. Okay, so there, here we are, over here. Why don't you do that? So get those eggs, crack them into a bowl.
Yeah!
You go. Go on then. That's it. Good. And the next one. Very nice. Go on. Delicately done. Well done. With not even a hint of eggshell in there. Very good. You've done a good job. And now pour it over all the bungalow heads here.
Oh, come on.
Oh, fresh eggs.
Oh, lovely.
Step three. I'll read them out. You do them. Step three. Add two buckets of flour. So we've got some flour over there. Do you want to add two buckets of flour?
Good job. Is it going to get all over your head?
Well, that's nice, Chef. Does it have to be any special flour? No.
Oh, yeah! Come on!
I might have to be the chef in a minute, actually.
Should
it? Yeah. Tip it all over them. Oh, flour. Step four. Okay, next, add a bucket of very runny lard. No, very runny lard here. Yeah, yes, we'll get some very runny lard and pour it all over their heads. Oh, how come you're doing it? You said you're the chef.
I'm helping.
All right, whatever. Go on, all over their heads. Oh, there you are. Yeah. That's it. Oh, yeah. All right. Step five. Add 2 tablespoons of warm water. Not boiling. Warm. Okay, 2 tablespoons of warm water. That's right. Flick it at them. In fact, just pour the whole lot over them. Oh, lovely. All right. And now step six, mix in 2 buckets of mashed bananas. There we are. 2 buckets of mashed bananas. And pour it all over their heads. Go on.
Hello.
Oh. Over their
heads. Oh, yeah.
Over their heads. Come on, Dick and Harry. Over there, that's our mix. Now mix it up. It's a self-mixing bowl, but it mixes itself up. Oh, sweet. Next step is
mix it up.
Mix in a bucket of vanilla extract. Have we got yes? Very good. Vanilla extract. Chuck in a bit of that. In there, lovely. A bit of vanilla extract. Add some tinned tomatoes. Yeah. It's the Bungalow Delight.
It's Bungalow Delight.
Now, Roger, you can't do it. Okay, go on some mushy peas. Cherry on top. Oh, so go on, put the cherry on top. And now, if you would like to make this at home, here are the ingredients again. If you want to make this at home, here are the ingredients again. So don't forget, you need this. Okay, you will need 1 bungalow head, 2 large eggs, 500 grams of flour, any kind will do. Lard, preferably from pig's fat. 2, we want 1 tablespoon of warm water, not boiling, that would hurt. 2 to 3 drops of vanilla extract, 3 bananas which are well mashed, 1 pound of tinned tomatoes, 8 ounces of mushy peas. If you would like mushy peas, you can always treat yourself by adding another 8 ounces of mushy peas. Some coloured icing just to decorate and finish it off with a nice cherry. There you go. And then, also, to finish it all off, you need some, you need a sponsor. And here is a word from our sponsor.
You up?
Nick and Dom, can you turn the immersion heater up? I'm feeling a bit parky.
And now simmer, along with some well-roasted Yvonne of the Yukon. Rat up a drain pipe.
Now, we've had many an email in this morning about one certain subject.
Yeah, about Raja. Yeah. I will just read a few highlights.
Nathan Logan says, somebody get rid of Raja, because he's getting on my nerves and wants to knock him with the mallet and whack him in his head.
Yeah, we've got one here from David Robertson, who's a Lemuel from Billingham, says, I think you should give him minus 999 and stick him in that flipping cage. Nice.
Smeb, a.k.a. Michael Webb, of Durham, says, I want to get rid of that mad giggly one. Rajar, I think his name is. On this week's show, you should put creamy muckmuck all over him.
Come on. Yeah. And what we have done is we've stuck him in the cage. So, that's better. Yeah, now, don't feel sorry for him.
No.
We will feed him some jelly.
Look, he's very happy. He's smiling. Look, he's happy in there.
What's in there? He will not be able to play any more games. He won't earn any more points. He's not even going to have a gungeon.
And most of all, he won't be able to make any more noise. Do you agree with him being in there?
Yeah.
Oh, listen. Daniela, go. Yes, in the forfeit hall, ginger up before Yvonne.
Very good.
We had this forfeit hall where Daniela became the hula kid. Every time she hears that, she has to hula.
Daniela? She's brilliant. Daniela, she lost 4 points because you took 4 seconds to do it. But I'm going to give you them back because you're really good.
Yeah,
good. In fact, I'm going to stick a zero on the end of that and call it 40.
Nice. And the other forfeit was the cookery kid. Enjoy it, Ramandeep and Tanya. Look at Tanya's hair. There's the end bits of it.
Not right.
For some reason, I wasn't even in it.
What? Look at my trousers. Look what happened.
Yeah, where were you?
I was just out the back in the garden.
What were you doing in the garden?
Just having a bit of fresh air. Having a chill with my radishes.
With your radishes?
And look what happened.
If you eat radishes, you won't have fresh air.
Unbelievable.
Think, the compost.
Enough about this. I think you need to go and have a...
All right, it's time to check this. What? I like you. I know. Actually, you're doing really well. Sit down.
Dilbert. No.
Alex. Come over here, mate. What is it? Superman! Thanks. Right then, Callum. Read out your score.
313.
Read out, for example, Tanya's score.
519.
Who's doing the best out of them two?
Daniel.
Who's doing the worst?
Me.
Would you like the opportunity to win some more points?
Yes.
In that case, you have got to slip up Superman.
Slip up Superman, Kevin! It's Superman in the Bungalow! You have 60 seconds on the clock in which to slip him to the ground. If you do it in, say, 20 seconds, then we'll give you the other score. The seconds will be turned into points. You can get 40 points. You can get more. Go!
No, oh, cut him up. No, don't beat him up.
He's a man of steel.
All you're going to do is trip him up, not beat him up.
Slip him up.
Get him on the floor. Just get down there and take his legs out.
I like his tits, girl.
Oh, don't kick him.
Two
bungalow points, Callie. Not bad, but not brilliant. Thank you very much.
Nice. And thank you very much. And go.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce you to a good friend of mine. First met him back in 1968 when he was working as a 24-hour monkey sponge in Rotherham. Please welcome with his latest and I think his funniest joke, Richard McCourt.
Thanks, Superman. Anyway.
Did I tell you the one about?
My mother.
My mother.
She's a fat horrible cow.
Oh!
Cat, fat,
horrible
cat. Oh, cat.
Yeah.
She's a fat, horrible cat.
And that's that.
Thank you very much. And that's that.
Right,
there we go. Thank you very much.
Every week in the Bungalow, we have a big person in the airing cupboard who likes to complain about something. And today, it's been him.
And when I go to the cinema, people just come and sit on my lap. I mean, I get my popcorn, and then suddenly they sat on me and squash my popcorn. It's most unacceptable. People ignore me. That's unreasonable. I like to do the hula dance, but I've got no midriff, so I can't do the hula dance. Just, oh, please don't expose me. I'm very embarrassed if you do that. Oh, that's nice. I like that. Very nice. Oh, look, a little bit of mime. How enchanting. Oh, look, stop it. Please don't express my little man boobs. I don't want them on show to the nation. Oh, get off me. Unhand me. Oh, no. Oh, I feel all temporary. Oh, no, my head. Oh, you bad boy. Oh, Mr. Wood, Mr. McCourt. Oh, I love you. I'll give you a hug. Oh, there's my head. Oh, I feel headless now. Now I'm without a head, and I really am absolutely up the water name.
Oh, it's time for the repetition competition.
Environmental expedition in rhetorical rendition using oral recognition. It's a verbal transmission with no points for omission. This is the definition of the Bungalow repetition competition.
The repetition competition.
Rhetorical rendition using oral recognition. It's a verbal transmission with no points for omission. This is the definition of the Bungalow repetition competition.
It's the repetition competition. And we need the person in first place and the person in third place to play this. So that is Tanya against Daniela. Come on over here, you two.
Tanya, have you been having fun?
Yeah.
Good. Now, this game is perfectly simple. We are going to read some words to you. Then you have to repeat the word back to us. Then we're going to say two words. You have to repeat two words back to us. Then three words back to us. Okay, got it?
You understand?
Right. Now, at the moment, who's in first place at the moment? It's Tanya. Tanya, you're in first place at the moment. And Daniela, you're in third. Sure. You win this, Tanya, you'll stay at the top. Daniela, if you win this, you'll take all her points and go to the top and she'll go to third.
So you've got to try and win it, all right? It's all to play for. First word is
cheese.
Cheese.
Cheese handlebars.
Cheese handlebars.
Cheese handlebars bullseye.
Cheese handlebars bullseye.
Cheese handlebars bullseye broomstick.
Cheese handle size.
We'll give you another go. Start from cheese again. Cheese.
Cheese. Handle.
Handle sheep.
Oh yeah, that was a clue. Handle.
Sheep.
Handle sheep. No nice sheep.
What noise?
No clues. Cheese. No, sorry.
No. You got three. Cheese, handlebars, bullseye. You were looking for handlebars there, Daniela.
Can I ask you a question?
Not handle sheep.
Does his breath smell? Yeah. Okay, thank you very much.
Does it really whiff of coffee and stuff? If you want to stay in first place, Tanya, then you've got to win.
It smells of old chimneys. Right then, Tanya. Are you ready? Three to be. Should be a diddly dog.
Three to be. Should be a
diddly doddle. No. Are you taking the mic?
No, we haven't started yet.
No, that was just me talking. How foolish.
Limp.
Limp.
Limp moustache.
Limp moustache.
Limp moustache. Hilda.
Limp moustache, Hilda.
For the winning one. Oh, yeah, Hilda. Limp moustache, Hilda, bucket.
Limp moustache, Hilda, bucket.
She's the winner! Well done, Tanya! You got four!
How many did you get?
I don't know, we never said.
How many do you think?
Oh, I don't know. What do you think? How many would you like?
In fact, because I've been so generous, you're just going to stay where you are.
There you are. In last first place.
What?
100 bungalow. Oh, 100 bungalow points.
You want 100 bungalow points?
Yes.
Oh, well, that's a cool club. I know, actually, the rules of the game are you just keep your place, but
she's asked, No, she just keeps the place. That's
please,
it.
Oh, 50.
End of game.
10.
No
eight,
more.
Five.
More. End of. We walked straight into that one. Thank you very much. That was the repetition competition.
The beginning of the end of the show!
Here's the beginning of the show. Come on, line up. Let's find out who the loser is or Dickadom in the bungalow on Sunday morning. Is it the man in the cage? Is it Raja in the cage? Is it Dilma, Daniela, Ramandeep, Khaled, or Tanya? Raja, Dilma, Daniela, Ramandeep, Khaled, or Tanya? The loser of Dickadom in the bungalow on the Sunday morning, of course, in the cage. It's Raja!
Now, are we actually going to use him to gunge him? Are we going to
do it? Of course we're going to gunge him. What do you think we're going to do? We're getting him out of the cage. He's off to the lab. Gunge him.
All right. Maybe we will.
Now then, you lot. We've had a bit of a mad weekend here in the bungalow, haven't we? Would you all like to have a think? Line up with them. Would you all like to have a think now about what's happened this week?
Just have a think about it.
Right, let's find out who's in third, second, and first place on Dickadom in the Bungalow this weekend. Here they are. Here's the scores with the winners and their names coming up on your TV screen now. In third place with a score of 420 is Daniela.
Second place, stand on your podium, Dilbert. You got 508.
And in first place, the winner of Dickadom in the Bungalow this weekend is Tanya with 519.
Quick, bring the prize now. Third prize,
Daniela. Daniela, you get that. Enjoy that. Second place, Dilbert, you get the DVD TV combi with DVDs. Enjoy that. And in first place, Tanya, you get the
James console.
Oh,
James.
Well, that's it from Bungalow. Hello.
Are you happy?
There's your TV,
Dilbert. There's your TV.
Are we ready to give Roger a very well deserved gunging? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, gunge! Roger!
Go on, Roger, take it off!
Yes. To the very last minute.
Nicely
he
said.
He couldn't have fluffed it up more if he tried.
Say what you think. Go on.
I am. Never again are we having people like him on this show.
But we love him, really. He's brought lots of entertainment to the nation this weekend.
I know. Time to get him.
We're back Saturday morning, 9 o'clock, TVBC1. See you then.
I am the cheeky boy, you are the cheeky girls. Touch my bum, this is life. Cheeky, cheeky.
Thank you very much to our very own cheeky boys, Dick and Dom. As we said, they'll be back 9 o'clock in the bungalow Saturday. Make sure you tune in. But now, you're stuck with Sophie and Barney.
Hi, how are you, Dick? I've never seen anybody.